Hello, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video. This time with another awesome sunrise image from the Lake of Constance in southern Germany. And for this image, I simply like to enhance the sunrise colors a little bit more, giving everything a warmer look, and maybe also apply a little bit of glow. For the editing, I will be just using Adobe Photoshop and maybe the Nicollection plugin as well. So before I start the editing, let's first check out the before and after images. Alright, and as I'm in Photoshop, the RAW editor might look a little bit different, but it's basically the same as Lightroom. First, of course, I want to activate the lens correction settings and then go back to the basic stuff. And right away, I want to change the profile to Adobe Landscape. And as you can see, this will just give the whole image some more saturation, which looks nice in this case. Then let's change the white balance. First, I want to increase the temperature to give everything a warmer look. And then let's drop the tint a little bit. Okay, now for the basic adjustments down here, I first want to increase the exposure since the base image is a bit too dark in my opinion. And of course, since this will result in some overexposure, especially down there with the bright highlights, I'm dropping the highlights. But I also don't care if there's a little bit of overexposure left in there. Alright, then let's also boost the vibrance a little bit for some more saturation. And because I think the image looks a little bit flat, I also want to increase the contrast. Alright, then it's time to work on the local adjustments for a moment. So let's head to the gradiated filters first. As you can see, I have applied three of those. Let's start on this weird one outside of the image on the left side, and that's because I want to cover the whole image but only affect a certain luminance range. That means I'm activating the range mask and set it to luminance. And as you can see right there, I am only affecting the luminance range up until a certain point. Everything above this point right here are just the very, very bright highlights of the image. And what I want to do with this filter, since the image is still a little bit dark, I want to simply increase the whites, but without affecting the brightest highlights of the shot. Then let's head to the next gradiated filter. And this one is for the sky, which I want to darken a little bit by dropping the exposure. Then I also want to add some clarity, which will give the clouds a little bit more structure. Maybe let's also add some tint right there. And let's apply some noise reduction to make this area just a little bit smoother. And then the last gradiated filter again is just for the sky. And I want to start by increasing the saturation slightly. Then again add some clarity. Maybe drop the temperature a bit. And again, add some noise reduction. Alright, that's it for the gradiated filters. Then I also have applied one radial filter right there over the brightest part of the image. And as you may guess, I want to add some glow in there. That means I'm simply increasing the blacks all the way up. Then I'm adjusting the color inside there by increasing the temperature to make the color fit the sunlight in the back. Alright, and that's it for the local adjustments. Now we can go on with some color grading in the HSL adjustments. Here I simply want to work on the saturation. So first I want to drop the blue tones and the purple tones just a little bit. And then I want to boost the orange ones and the red ones. That looks already quite nice. Then let's go to the split toning tab. Of course, since this is a warm sunrise shot, I also want to have warm highlight colors. So I'm going to change the hue a little bit. And then let's also apply a nice cold color tone for the shadows. Maybe even go slightly into the purple range. And let's boost the saturation. Alright, and then I want to do some final color grading in the calibration tab by adjusting the blue primary tones. That means I'm dropping the hue, which will just enhance those warm color tones a little bit more. And then let's boost the saturation. Alright, also let's apply some vignetting in the effects tab. And let's drop the amount. I think something like this looks nice. Then finally some sharpening. And then let's open the image. First, of course, I want to get rid of those sensor spots right there. So I'm using the spot healing brush for this and just paint over those spots. Let's see, maybe I also want to get rid of some of those rocks in the foreground. Next, since I did use a wide angle lens for this shot, some of those lines are a little bit distorted still. So I want to try and fix that by duplicating that layer. So I'm hitting Ctrl J and now I'm selecting the area I want to fix. So mainly back here. And now I'm hitting Ctrl T, right click in that area and go with distort. And now I'm simply picking this point right there and drag it to the left and make those lines straight again. Alright, then let's also apply a little bit of glow. So I want to create a new layer for that and switch the blending mode to hard light. Then I'm picking up the brush tool and select a nice warm color from that bright area on the left side. Let's make it a little bit warmer and give it some more saturation. And now I want to apply a little bit of glow, especially for those lights. But first I'm dropping the brush opacity to not make it too strong. And then I'm just painting over those lights a little bit. Okay, and I maybe can also add some glow on the left side. But I want to keep it subtle, so that's it for adding the glow. Then I want to merge those two layers by selecting them and hitting Ctrl E. And then let's check the Nick collection for some final effects. In this case, I want to go with the polarization effect, since this will help a little bit more with the contrast and the colors of the image if I'm increasing the strength. And I think something like this looks pretty cool. Okay, and at this point I want to stop the editing, so I hope this was interesting and helpful. Of course, if you have any questions, let me know in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.